أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear friends, today we will mention something about the balance in treating the kids, especially boys and girls. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked one time by companion to bear witness that he gave, I think, a piece of land to one of his children. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, did you give everyone the same? He said, no. He told him, I don't bear witness on wrong thing. So he would not agree on this behavior, because he wasn't fair to all the kids the same way. So we have to be very careful. The children are crisp, brand new machine, smarter than the smartphone. They hear and see and pick up hidden signals which make them feel that they are not treated equally. One of the experiments, it's available on YouTube, it's a psychological experiment where the researcher had two gorillas or chimpanzees, and he was feeding them the same thing, cucumber, pieces of cucumber. And they were eating, taken from his hand. They are in a cage. And no problem. The minute the researcher gave one of them a grape, the other one was irate and he was jumping and angry and doing all kinds of things to express his displeasure. He sensed he wasn't treated right. So we also, our children, sense when they are not treated right, and when the children are, there is some kind of appreciation to one of them more than the other. Very sensitive, and can affect the life in all its entirety. We know that our life is translation to our childhood, and what we go through this childhood. We have to be very, very careful. By gesture, by smile, by hugging, by kissing, by spending quality time with them, we have to be fair to the max. Otherwise, that can spill problems down the line, in the family, among the siblings, and later on when they get married, the problem get bigger. And another occasion, when a man was in the presence of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and his son, the son of that man, came and he welcomed him and put him on his lap, and very soon followed by his daughter, who came close, and he told her, sit down there. So she sat down in front of him. And here the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of mercy and kindness, he told him, هَلَّا عَدَلْتَ بَيْنَهُمَا. Why? You did not treat them equal. We, all of us, we know that girls, the babies, from the time they are born, raising them up, learning the lawful and unlawful, memorizing Quran, being sent to college, career, pharmacist, doctor, lawyer, that's your passport to heaven. If you raise two or three or even one, So we have to be very, very careful in not differentiating between boys and girls. All of them are precious, and they are equal in the sight of God. They are equal in everything we're supposed to do, of salah, fasting, and charity, and pilgrimage, everything is the same, and the reward is the same in the hereafter. Some differences based on the physiology and anatomy of male and female require some differences in our situations, but that doesn't mean anything worse or not equal, and so on. So we have to be very, very careful. This is a serious subject and can exacerbate already existing sibling rivalry. Lot of stories from Cain and Abel. And John Steinbeck, he had a story, East of Eden. It was about two brothers, twins, East of Eden. Because of that differentiation, one of them was very miserable, almost needed a psychiatrist. The second one was welcomed, everything and so on, and turned out to be, you know, very messy situation. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.